All is well with you and yours. I am excited to be here with you. I got some new lights installed, although I'm having some issues with my camera. So hopefully that does not cause an issue. I'm really happy to be here with you and excited to share with you the footage from the Battle of Bunny Flats. I hope that you are ready for that. Grab a vegan snack. I will be munching on this delicious veggie tray that I made. Obviously celery, carrots, and cucumber, but this is a vegan cheese dip. It's actually originally the recipe is for a cheese ball, but I like to eat it fresh before it goes into the refrigerator and gets hardened, and some ranch dressing as well, and some hot tea in my vegan mug. Animals are friends, not food, of course. So let us get ready to jump into the Battle of Bunny Flats. Some background information, those of you who don't already know, I host full moon celebrations on Mount Shasta, where I bring a buffet of homemade vegan delicious food up to Mount Shasta. At this point, it's, you know, gotten better every year. Now I have like catering equipment, some Schaefer's, I have tablecloths, and it's basically just getting upgraded every year to become better and better. And I have had issues in the past with people trying to bring in non-vegan food. If you remember from last year, I actually had an interaction with two guys that were trying to, one of them was trying to pass out macaroni and cheese, and the other one was trying to, you know, put it on his plate and then consume it. I had to physically escort these guys out of my circle, and I actually wanted to play that footage for you before we continue on to the Battle of Bunny Flats audio footage, so that you can know what I have dealt with before and what I was, you know, expecting to deal with going into the Battle for Bunny Flats. So here is that footage now.
This is my event. This is my event. This is my sacred circle. Please take that out of the circle. Please take it out of the circle. Please take it out of the, eat it outside of the circle. Have some respect. Get the fuck out. I don't give a fuck what they
need.
I don't care.
Get the fuck off.
I'm not gonna leave. My soul has ties to this land. Okay?
Please keep looking.
I don't even know what that word means, little millennial. Please just walk away. Please don't eat that in my circle, okay? What are you? Like, seriously.
What are you? Go
this
away.
This is a event for vegans.
So that was just one of the reasons that I was expecting to have issues going into the Battle of Bunny Flats. Not only that, but I contacted a local, very talented vegan artist named Baruch to create this poster to promote the vegan festival. I got it printed out in color. I even paid for it to be laminated, and I took it to Berry Vale in Mount Shasta, posted it on the community board, and at least 3, 4, maybe even 5 times, this poster was taken down. So someone in the community, some people in the community, people were having issues with the poster and taking it down. It wasn't Berry Vale, you know, taking the poster down. And not only was that post, physical post in real life, getting trolled, but, you know, online I posted the same thing in multiple different groups, and people were trolling that as well, saying, let's go have a barbecue in the parking lot. And one person even said that, you know, don't have a fire. Law enforcement will be waiting for you when you get there. I have dealt with law enforcement a lot. Every time that I go up there, I obviously go up early to set up. And between the time that I get up there to set up and the time that the event starts, I've usually dealt with law enforcement, with Forest Service, with firefighters. So, you know, I'm used to dealing with these types of individuals. As a hostess of the party, of the event, I not only go out and get the permit for the fire, but if there are any issues, like, I'm the point of contact with these people. So I'm used to dealing with them already. And actually, they were up there when I got up there. There were two different vehicles sitting there. And the parking lot, you know, was down here. And the place that I was actually setting up the event was up a little bit up a hill. And so I'm unloading the car, everything's out, and I'm making trips up and down, you know, from the parking lot up to where this is set up, and just thinking, I'm like, I swear, if these guys sit over here and watch me single-handedly struggle bringing all of this stuff up and down, up and down, up and down, like, and then set it all up, and then come up here and say, you know, you're not allowed to have this party, or, you know, just try to do any of that, like, I'm really gonna flip out. So, thankfully, they did not do that. But before I got to interact with them, I'm setting up, and there's a family up there by where I was setting up the event, and a little girl was there. This is relevant, obviously, because of the audio clip I'm about to play. I'm setting up. You can hear that I'm out of breath because I'm just kind of like a workhorse, I guess. I'm just up and down. That's not really a vegan thing to say, I guess. But anyways, just like, I didn't stop for a break. I'm like, I just want to get this all over with. And then once it's set up, I'll just take a break and relax. So anyways, I'm setting all this up. This hiker comes down the hill and, you know, we start talking about the event. And I wanted to play this clip because of what the little girl says at the end. Pretty much from the time that I get up there to the time that I leave, I have my phone audio recording at the very least in case anything happens. Obviously, I've had the interaction with the drunk provocateurs before, but anything, you know, anything interesting, anything that happens, you know, I want to have it recorded so that I have it recorded, not just for me, but, you know, if something happens and I have to end up in court, it's like I have this audio recording that, you know, can potentially solidify my case in court and, you know, show the judge what was happening in the situation. So anyways, here is this little audio clip while I am setting up.
Are you guys having a whole party up here?
Yep. A vegan festival. Yes, sir.
Very good.
Sounds better than roasting the flesh of the innocent at the meeting place of heaven and earth. Well, that's your demon speaking, buddy.
I like your logic. Hopefully you were able to hear that. That is just really cool that, you know, that happened. That, you know, children can see that, right? Children, if you try to hand one an apple and a rabbit, it's like the fruit, they're gonna naturally gravitate, that's not a good word, naturally lean towards, right? Rather than, what are they gonna do with this rabbit? They're not gonna try to eat it, like, that's just, maybe pet it and kiss it and all, I mean, I guess it depends what developmental stage they are. Babies try to put everything in their mouth, but you get the point, right? They're not gonna try to get this idea of skinning this animal and consuming its flesh. They're gonna go for the tasty, tasty fruit. So anyways, after I got everything set up for this event, I go there hours ahead of time before the event starts at sundown to set up. I break out my guitar and you'll hear that Tom comes down the hill. Tom has been at pretty much every one of my events. I can't think of one that he hasn't been at. And when the provocateurs were there, you know, within a few minutes, once everything started getting loud, Tom was right there, you know, in case anything happened, to have my back. I consider Tom a really good friend, and this will obviously become relevant later. So, here is the audio.
When a storm has come, with thunder and lightning, when the battle's on. World says we won't make it, and I don't think that.
Tom? How's it going? Yeah. We're going to do the fire up there. Make a little circle up there and...
Nice. I didn't have the greatest experience at the Sand Flat last time I was there.
Oh, really? What happened?
Well, it's just like, when you get this, people think you're like a pro, you know, like you got a gun and you're one of these...
Oh, because you got a goatee?
Yeah, this is like the longest I've grown it ever. And so some of the younger...
Hey, who's flying drones? Go away.
I wanted to make 2 points here. The most important point being, Tom is talking about having this negative interaction, this negative experience at Sand Flat at a drum circle, which will become relevant later. And the second point was that you can hear the drone. And the night that this took place, the lava fire actually started, and multiple times during the lava fire, the helicopters going back and forth, the air travel to and around the fire, going back and forth with water, whatever, multiple times had to be stopped because of a drone. So I kind of think it's a little bit interesting that people were flying drones over top of me as well. It's quite irritating.
Oh, yeah, what's that about?
If I had a gun, I'd shoot them.
Yeah, I mean, they crash. They
respect people's privacy.
Yes, I know that I'm in public, so it's kind of funny to say respect people's privacy while you're in public. And, you know, whatever. But this conversation was private, so I'm not going to be playing the rest of it. But I am going to play another clip. You'll hear me talking to somebody who's descending down the mountain. And at the end, you're going to hear Dustin walking up. For those of you who don't know, I've made videos, you know, regarding Dustin before. Dustin started following me on YouTube, on Facebook, like many years ago. And we have met in person. I can't really say that any of the interactions have been very positive. But anyways, you're going to hear him enter into the scene at the end of this clip.
Right. Hello. Well, it's a vegan event, and it starts at sundown. Yes. Awesome. We don't sacrifice innocents here in this holy mountain. So. How's it going?
So that was Dustin's voice. You hear he walks over, sits on a log, and I continue to talk to Tom. Eventually, Tom comes around to talking about playing the flute. I got a big smile on my face because this is just something that Tom, you know, I associate Tom with playing the flute. He's just always playing the flute at drum circles. It's really important to him. He takes it very seriously, and obviously this will again become more relevant later. In this next clip, I really just love Tom. You're going to hear him talking about this flute business, so just check this out.
I didn't do any breathing exercises to really guarantee I'm going to be able to play
to flute like, it up.
To flute it up really big time. But we'll see. I found that eating a lot of beets and stuff helps metabolize.
Beets?
Yeah, beets and beet juice and stuff is really good for metabolizing the oxygen to your blood.
My dad used to eat beets, and I would like pretend to like them just to please him. I thought it would like make him happy if I like beets, so I would like take a bite and then cringe, like go under the table and hide my face, just grossed out. I haven't had beets since I was really young though, so.
Yeah.
I am quite a picky vegan, just so everybody who doesn't already know knows.
I do have a permit, and actually.
Okay, cool.
So you're going to do the same method where you have like
well, a container. Well, I'm going to organize the rocks into a circle, and we might dig a little hole just to put it in, and then we can actually cover it back up in the morning. But the cops already came up and, you know, tried to talk to me and stuff. And, yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
And they were saying basically that other people might come up and I need to respect them, and I'm like, I'm just going to tell you right now that I don't respect innocent abusers. Jesus went into the table and flipped temples.
Went to the table and flipped temples. Yeah, this is one of the many times in this night that, like, my words are getting mumbled. Like, just, I feel like I was under curse energy that evening just for different parts of the event to go wrong. You know, it's like when I put out that I'm having this event, all of my enemies, you know, basically gang up on me, and because they're lives are really pitiful and their basically existence is solely to fuel this war against me, it's like they jump at the opportunity to try to put curse energy, and it can manifest in different ways. You know, obviously bad weather, which is something that's going to be coming up in a little bit, and jumbling words, having other issues as well. So
when people were doing evil things, like if we see people doing evil, we have an obligation to stand up and do something about it. So
yeah, that's right.
He's like, so just you know, respect what they're doing. And I'm like, dude, I just told you that I do not respect animal abusers, like so we'll see. I've had some people, I actually had Baruch, you know Baruch?
Yeah.
I had him make a flyer for the event.
Oh.
And I laminated it, printed out, laminated it, and was sticking it up at Berry Vale. At least four times, someone has removed the poster, taken it down. It's like, you guys are pathetic.
It's understandable that the corruptors have to attack me. You know, it's part of this reality that we are in. I am desperately trying to purify, to spread the light, and those, you know, in the powers that be, the darkness, those dark forces are desperately trying to snuff out the light, trying to suppress it, trying to shadow ban it, trying to make sure that humans don't see it, you know?
Yeah, if there's like serious enemies, we gotta keep an eye on them so they don't come around and affect the food.
That's what I've actually been worried about too.
Less the food when you cooked it and stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe we put good energy into it. But make sure they don't come around and do something to the food. I mean, I'm not saying that's gonna happen, but that I kept an eye on.
Tom is such a great guy. Like, not only is he expressing concern over the issue, but he's already, like, he's saying he's already, like, at my events, sat around and watched just in case, keeping an eye on it, actively, like, trying to protect the event and make sure that any enemies are thwarted. You have something white underneath your eye right there.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Kind of moved it out a little bit more. Almost. There you go. Now you're going to get it with your shirt. Oh, a little bit left. Let me just get a napkin. I actually got a napkin and wiped his face. Like, yeah.
Yeah. I got information from some of my UFO people that there was an encounter where the aliens are saying, be vegan, you know, be vegetarian, vegan. They'll be able to communicate better with you and all
right.
That stuff.
Well, there's one yogi, I don't remember their name, but they say that anytime you eat meat, you actually shut down your higher centers, your sixth and seventh chakras, so it definitely has a negative impact on it.
I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce the name, but Sangto Singh Khalsa, based on my own research with muscle testing, anytime that you eat animal flesh, you shut down your sixth and seventh chakras. So even a few times a week will have a significant effect on your consciousness. And fish, instead of being less of a problem, also affects your lower digestion. It is clear for those of us who are working hard through yoga and meditation to open our higher centers and experience our divine essence, that meat, fish, and eggs are working in the opposite direction. All right. So in this next clip, you are going to hear Dustin speaking.
What I've learned, most people that I've met that think they've talked to you and met you don't know anything about you and need to just shut the fuck up because it's like stupid.
Yeah.
Well, they think that I'm evil and all this stuff because I enforce veganism. It's like, wait a second. So you're saying that the one who isn't sacrificing animals is evil? Are you backwards? Like, yes, you are.
Well, and plus, like, I don't know, like, they're a bunch, they're like, oh, well, I don't want to judge people, and I don't want to,
but they judge me.
But yeah, they're gonna judge you. Oh, is that biodegradable makeup? It's like, why do you even care? I mean, did you ask her? How about that? Instead of just insulting the lady behind your back, ask her.
For non-vegans who don't judge anyone, you know, they accept all sorts of degeneracy and corruption, it's like them trying to judge me is absolutely ridiculous. Also, you know, my makeup obviously is a vegan. As far as the biodegradable stuff goes, it's like my focus isn't being a vegan. And if I could find a biodegradable vegan product, that's awesome. But right now, veganism is the focus, right? It's more important that you stop animal testing and stop actually directly hurting the animals than having something that's made out of plastic. In the future, having hemp replace all of the plastic stuff, having biodegradable materials that don't create these huge landfill messes and make humans look like disgusting parasites, you know, that is something in the future to work for. But, you know, why do you care more about something being biodegradable than it actually coming from hurting an animal? Doesn't make sense. Dustin also mentions in these conversations that he's actually been undermining my message. You know, I constantly say that I am willing to fight, kill, and die over this message. My soul came here for war. And Dustin's going around telling people, you know, that I'm peaceful, that I wouldn't hurt a fly, like, you know, that I'm gentle and I wouldn't get involved with violence. And I mean, I've already physically pushed two guys out of my circle, and if it has to escalate, I am more than willing to do that, because at the end of the day, if you aren't willing to stand up for your beliefs, you know, even to the point of death, then what are you? Like, for me, that's something that I find really, important. And, you know, so I'm going to go through with that. My soul, ultimately, I know that death is not the end, and dying in battle for what I know is right, what I like over the animals, right? Dying over protecting the innocents, that is something that you can be really proud of. And yeah, so as far as, yeah, it's just really irritating, because if you want to come to Mount Shasta and say, you know, I'm here because I'm a follower of Inanna, or I'm her friend, or, you know, I'm part of her army and all of this stuff, but then you want to go behind my back and, you know, basically, not even basically, just completely, absolutely undermine my message and basically shoot me in the foot by going around and contradicting while saying that you're my friend and my fault. Like, it just doesn't just stop. Like, I have enough of that from inverted clowns, from CIA ass hats, from other alphabet soup clowns that want to pretend to be my friend, pretend to be on my side, and undermine me the whole time, try to promote corruption in every different manner, and, you know, they swarm me. So it's already irritating enough that I have that going on with people, and I don't need it from people who are truly my friends and really, you know, there to support me. And I have told people, you know, multiple times, I'm not looking for people that are going to come here to Mount Shasta to be problematic. I'm looking for people that are going to be assets, people that have their stuff together, spend this time right now preparing for what is coming, getting ready as prepared as you can be to come to Mount Shasta and survive here on your own two feet and not need, like, I'm not in a position where I can give everybody everything. And, you know, in the golden age, I will have resources to be able to give and to be able to completely take care of, you know, those that are deciding that they want to be in my queendom. But right now, it's like we are all trying to get ready for going in through the tribulation. And the more prepared that we are, you know, the better off that we will be. So it's like, I don't need people that are liabilities, that are going to undermine me, that are going to cause problems for me. I need people that are going to be strong assets, that know what their soul came here for, and that are actually ready for battle, that have their mind, you know, their mindset clear. They have their vision clear of what they want for the future, and ultimately the vision clear for the golden age, right? Like, that's what we are ultimately fighting for, whether our own little separate, you know, dreams and fantasies or whatever, you know, are all aligned. It's like the bigger picture is the golden age, and that's what we need to focus on. And I'm looking for people that are on the same, you know, path as me, on that same thing, that are gonna help that, help advance the war for the golden age, not cripple my army, not cause issues. So Yeah. And so for the next audio clip from the Battle of Bonnie Flats, I need to play an audio clip from before. The clip from Bunny Flats is going to be Dustin talking about an event that happened at the park when we met at the park. He was with this guy named Tony at the park, and you know, usually I have it set up to where I meet people during my full moon events, and it's like I have a busy schedule otherwise, so I don't really like, you know, I have a certain schedule when I'm available for public, and then, you know, other times I'm not. It's like I'm not just a free to the public 100% of the time. You can come to Mount Shasta and I'm going to drop everything and run to you. Like, that's just not realistic. I have a life. I have things that I have to take care of. But Dustin, you know, was really like, please come to the park. Please come to the park. So I'm like, okay, I'll come to the park and see what's going on. As soon as I, you know, walk down the hill and meet him, like, I hug him and I can just smell the alcohol on his breath. So it's like already, I'm like, oh my gosh. I personally really don't like to deal with drunk people. Like, you know, I do like to drink myself. I don't like to get drunk. There's like a, you know, there's a happy medium, having a buzz, whatever, than being drunk. But anyways, the point is, him and Tony were there in Mount Shasta to celebrate Tony's birthday. So, you know, they're drinking, they're having a fun time, whatever. We start walking around the park, just, you know, what's up, whatever. And Dustin's talking to me about, you know, how they're upset that there's only one McDonald's in an area, which is like, okay, but McDonald's, what do they even have that's vegan? So a vegan shouldn't be complaining that there's only one McDonald's in a space. And then not only that, but then continuing on to talking about how they were buying Happy Meals for children. And, you know, again, if you're going to come to Mount Shasta and say that you are fighting on my team, on my army, that you are part of my circle, and then you are turning around and talking about feeding children McDonald's, like, that is something that I would never do. I don't care what the parents say, right? Like, if I was in a situation and their mom says, go feed them McDonald's cheeseburger, like, they're adamant about it. It's like, if you want to take your own child and feed them poison, I don't have the power to do anything to stop that, but I certainly am not going to buy your child any poison. The last thing I'm going to do is sit there and watch your child eat it. Like, I'm not going to be involved with that evil. I think that it is absolutely immoral. So those of you who are, you know, coming and saying, I'm here with you, I'm part of your army, I'm on the golden age, don't be undermining my message, right? You can't be going around buying kids Happy Meals behind my back and then pretending like you're on my team. You're literally working against me actively, and you're poisoning children. You are corrupting their mind, body, and soul. Like, that is completely against everything that I stand for. I'm getting worked up, but you can see, like, some of these issues that I am having, you know, in this situation where I have to deal with people that are saying they're my supporters coming to Mount Shasta, you know, and I don't want to be mean, but it's like pestering me to, like, you know, do things and trying to make me look bad online, you know, like, I came out here to see you and now you won't go, like, making drama that, you know, it's just a whole big situation that doesn't need to be. It's like, come during the full moon celebrations and we have all night to spend together. And then, you know, if we kick it off, if we hit it off or whatever, then we can go from there. But it's like, I don't want any of this drama, okay? And it's not just that. Well, let me actually just play the clip here for you. This is, we're like sitting in the park, and at some point, you know, towards the end of the conversation, Tony comes up and, well, you'll hear it, okay? I would never.
Hey, we're too long now. Do you want to hang out? You guys want to come on my birthday, or what are you guys doing?
Go with him.
No, you guys should both come.
Well, I have other plans.
You have other plans?
Yeah.
He loves you.
I understand. Well, we'll see. We'll meet up another time, I promise.
Tony, are you leaving right now?
Well, you can meet up with us later. I can get you a ride.
She's already like, I know, are you leaving right now?
I didn't mean to interrupt. I'm just saying, if she loves you, she would come jam with you.
No, I have other plans, and I came out of my way to do this tonight, so it's not... It's just like the last
my birthday, and this guy hasn't seen you so long.
I know, dude. I don't.
Okay, alright.
Are you leaving?
So, I'm following you.
Leaving. Come on.
Okay. So, I wanted to bring you some food. And this is some vegan cheese that I just made.
So
it's really good with vegetables. Yeah.
Give me a whole bag of food.
Hopefully you heard in there him saying, if she loves you, she would come jam with you. It's like, what? I barely even know this guy. Love? What are you even talking about? Like, this is just ridiculous, right? So anyways, we leave the park. He heads to this party with Tony. And then later that night, like, my Facebook starts getting blown up. Like, I need a ride. Come get me. We had a fight. Like, all of this drama that, you know, inevitably follows drunk people that are drinking liquor, that are, you know, going out to party in this situation, you know, causing just so much headache and dramas. Like, I'm not gonna, like, my car was having issues at the time. It was like really late at night. I'm like, I'm not gonna leave my home. I already came out of my way once to see you today against what I had. Like, I had other things planned. I came out of my way to come see you, and now you're like blowing me up and trying to make me feel guilty and all of this stuff over your own drama that you know, I didn't ask you to be in this situation. Like, if you're coming here to deal with me, you're not going to be doing all of these things. It's a totally different mindset, not running around with, you know, hippie travelers that want to consume liquor. And I'm not saying anything negative against them. I'm just saying, like, I don't support drinking liquor. You know, a lot of the people that he was hanging out with don't like me. They talk bad about me. It's just like not the situation that should be in, especially if you're, you know, getting drunk and undermining me and then making me look ridiculous because, you know, now they're trying to say that I'm associated with this clown. And I'm like, I'm not associated with this clown. They are, you know, parasiting off of me. So anyways, back to the Battle of Bunny Flats. So we had that whole situation with Tony at the park, all of his drama. So this is what Dustin is referencing in this next audio clip.
When Tony did that, I was like so embarrassed. And it wasn't like, it was just for myself, you know? Because I knew that, like, he's not the kind of person I wanted to bring around. And so, like, that's why I told him. I was like, dude, I'm going to be over here.
Right.
Just give me 30 minutes, an hour, whatever. I didn't know he was going to be like, oh, I'm leaving now. But that's what happens when, you know, you drink whiskey like that. It's pretty wild.
Right. Well, I actually met him last year, I think, at my event down here, and yeah, that didn't really go so smoothly.
He's not one of the ones that was being aggressive that you had to make.
Oh, no, those were Indian guys.
That wasn't him.
No,
I'm just saying, because I can see him acting like that.
They were supposedly Native Americans, which actually aren't even Native Americans. They're actually Siberian migrants, so that's going to be really fun.
I just can see him acting like that, you know? Like,
yeah.
Just being crazy.
Yeah, I've heard that, too. They come across stuff.
The Bering Strait.
The Bering Strait, yeah.
And actually, there were giants here before they came, and they came and killed the giants.
This land, other lands, you know, has been occupied by not only human, you know, different groups of humans, but even other species before humans. So, you know, especially the species that were created long before humans that occupied this land, you know, for them to see humans claiming the land is like, it's kind of funny because, you know, it was ours first. But anyways, I also wanted to mention that before this Battle of Bunny Flats happened, as the full moon event approached, I had, you know, Dustin had commented on some of my YouTube videos, and I commented, you know, at least 6 times with the same message, which is quoted, I'm worried about you and Tony showing up to my event drunk and causing issues. So I was extremely worried about this after the park incident. And thankfully, like, Tony actually didn't come to this event, but you will see later that we still did have issues. So anyways, I'm in this next clip going to be talking about some of, at least one of the different allegations that have been made against me by the anti-Inanna factions. So here is that.
Someone tried to say that I, like, went up to a ski bowl and put salt around their car and like curse them. And I'm like, honey, all magic comes with a price. I'm not willing to get uglier just to curse you when you're already cursed. Like,
all magic comes at a price. And if you are going to go around cursing people, that's going to come back to you. Like I said, I'm not willing to sacrifice any of my beauty to curse you, no matter who you are, no matter what kind of sour energy you have sent my way, or any of that. It's like, you are not worth it. You, by, you know, cursing me, by coming against me, I see you as a lost, cursed soul anyways. Like, you are lost. You don't know what is best for you. And the last thing that I need to do is to add to that confusion, add to that curse that you are under, so I'm not gonna curse you. Like, it's just, yeah. Anyways, ultimately, yeah, I want my haters to go vegan and to purify themselves. I don't want to see them become more corrupt and lost, because they're already corrupt and lost. I want to create a golden age, and it's beautiful to see, you know, a soul get purified and turn from evil and become, you know, the best version of themselves possible.
It's not just a stopping of the animals. Like, I want humans to be free too. I want you to be able to not have to work, to be able to go and live life as you want, to travel. So it's not just the animals. It's like, humans, hello, why are you fighting me when I'm trying to liberate you too?
That's what I'm saying. That's
what, oh, because it comes with the liberation of the animals, and, you know, they just can't give up their flesh.
Like, it's definitely truly disappointing that people don't care enough about the animals to go vegan, and then they don't care about themselves. It's like, not only do you lack the empathy for the animals, but if you truly cared about yourself, you're going to be filling your temple with things that extend your life, that make you healthier, rather than the death that you're consuming, that you are literally prematurely aging and killing yourself with. In this clip, you're going to hear how windy it was getting later. This freak storm, like, you'll hear everybody, well, not everybody, but you'll hear multiple people talking about how crazy this storm is.
Okay, God, that's enough. I won't blame God, because we don't know if they're modifying the weather.
Yeah, the storm was really unnatural, and the lava fire that started was supposedly from lightning, which, yeah, I don't know about that one, but hey. Anyways, in this next clip, you're going to hear Tom talking about these 99-cent vegan chips that he bought. He was really excited to have found these chips and share them with me. So I wanted to share this with you. I just really love Tom.
99 cents is a pretty good deal, too.
I know. I should have bought one. I mean, I should have went to the car, ate some right away, and then came right back. I don't mind beans, but I'll admit, they do make you
feel. It doesn't really taste like beans, though, so it's kind of like...
Yeah, it's like green peas and yellow peas. Wait a minute.
I don't even like peas, so it's kind of like...
Oh, yeah, then black beans. Is it No, you don't like peas.
Oh, no.
What, like split pea soup? Oh, man, that's
it. I only have eaten green peas intentionally once, and that was because my aunt said she'd give me a dollar if I ate a spoonful.
Wow.
So I said yes, thinking that it was like a small spoon, and then she gets like the biggest spoon out, and I'm like, wait a second, it was the work. Oh. It was not worth it. Well, for me, it's about a moral issue, so it's like, I don't care if I... Hello. Having a vegan festival for the full moon.
Dude, you're so vegan.
Cool.
I love you. Maybe do you hug?
Sure.
Because I want to hug you. That's cool. Yeah, we saw you on the way up, and I was like, we're camping right down there.
Oh, cool. Well, the food's on its way up, so hopefully it'll stop raining.
It's just a little rainy cloud.
Right.
Just, yeah.
Well, the trees need it too, so I can't really complain too much.
Cool. How long is the thing going to last?
Well, we're starting at sundown, and we'll be up here until the sun comes up, so.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yep.
Yay.
I feel the mountain here. This will be the first, because they usually have them somewhere else.
We usually go all the way up to the top.
Oh, that's super cool. Yeah.
ecstatic dance tonight and then come back.
Cool.
Mount Shasta is a portal, very high spiritual activity, many entities entering and exiting our realm. And especially as we go into the tribulation, there is more activity going on, you know, the veil being lifted, and Bigfoot, Lemurian, UFO, alien sightings are a common theme around Mount Shasta. So you'll hear a lot of people talking about them. And in this next clip, me and Tom are talking about them.
Yeah, here you'll get to see the moon pop right up, and then you'll any kind of UFO activity will be seen. Those flickers, that flicker light that I told you about, I've already seen it twice this year.
Oh wow!
And like last week, but we saw them a bunch of times, and they're just unexplainable because they vanish and whatever they are, it's kind of stealthy. So we think they're still around checking us out. I telepath to it, you know, to visit. Come on down.
Take me with you.
Well, I asked also if it was a time traveler.
And what is that?
Oh, I didn't get an answer back.
I personally don't believe in time travel.
Well, even if you're multidimensional and not physical.
Well, time is like a linear thing, so you can't go back and you can't go forward. It already happened. Like.
Yeah, it could be right. I don't know for a fact any of that. Yeah, I figured if they're going faster than gravity.
Well, I don't believe in gravity either, so.
Speed of light, too.
I don't really believe in the speed of light either, so this is the thing. Yeah, I'm a flat earther, so yeah. I don't believe in a lot of the things that we're taught science-wise. But
I did want to mention, as far as the UFO sightings go, there is a spacecraft that our own government, U.S. government, makes that looks just like a UFO. And in that last clip, it was like the weather had cleared up. In this next clip, you're going to hear it being really windy. At one point, an empty water bottle starts to fly down this hill. So I'm like running down to try to catch it. You're going to hear, you know, another guy come up, and this is Michael. He is actually trying to help grab the bottle as well. He brought some doggies with him.
Vegan full moon celebration. Oh. Yep. What was that? We're going to get some down. Ooh, okay, let's stop. Thank you. Oh no. Okay. I'm Inanna, by the way.
Inanna.
About the summer goddess Inanna?
Sumerian goddess of love and war. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Oh, book.
Oh, really?
Her lover.
Cool.
That's cool. Who's invited?
Is it a patron? It's open to the public. As long as people don't come and cause problems.
Oh, yeah. Sundown?
Yep. Cool. Yep, are you camping up here then? Or just come
I'm down
up
at McBride.
Okay.
Yeah, camping there.
Nice. You walk all the way up here?
No, I got a car. Okay. I got a truck and an Airstream down there.
Hello. Hi.
Two dogs. That one's Gloria.
Hi, Gloria.
And, this is Pearl, and I'm Michael.
Michael, nice to meet you.
So Michael and I talk for a while. Eventually he leaves, and my friend Dave, the drummer, arrives.
You need some help here?
No, I'm going to go stir this cheese really quick, but everything's pretty set up.
Keep this up here for now.
Yeah, I have extra trash bags if it starts to rain and you want to put one over your drum so it doesn't get wet.
Dave, like Tom, has pretty much been at every one of my drum circles, and he has, you know, supported me enforcing veganism in my circle. So, yeah, like to play drums and guitar with Dave as well, so that's always fun.
But they want us fighting each other. That's the whole thing, right? Let's just keep us fighting each
well,
other.
Well, 100 years ago during the Spanish flu, they started race wars too.
Yeah, yeah.
They want to get us to fight each other so they don't have to do anything.
I agree.
A while back, it was a channel to me that every 100 years, the four horsemen, you know, pestilence, famine, war, death, ride and depopulate the earth. So, you know, 100 years ago during Spanish flu, a lot of these same
types of things happened that are happening right now, including them trying to incite race wars, trying to get us to divide and conquer based on every single little issue rather than coming together as one species, regardless of race, regardless of other things, to ultimately, you know, stand against them and manifest a reality that makes us happy, that makes us not slaves anymore.
I'm the first, you know, someone was just beating, at least me. I don't want to see a trans person beat the hell in the parking lot. I'd probably stop him. But I don't want
if it was a guy dressed as a girl who just tried to seduce you, I wouldn't, I would not step in the way if you beat the snot out of him, because
ultimately I have family members, I have younger brothers that I'm very protective over. And if a MTF tried to seduce my little brothers, you know, I mean, they already have, right? They're already in media. They already have successfully done that. But in real life, it's a little bit different. I'm not going to stop anybody from receiving the backlash that they get if they are trying to deceive people and they get their lights knocked out. Anyways, check out my Transvestigation 101 video. I'll leave a link below to that. And here is the next clip.
Well, I don't like how they go to the kids.
Right.
So then they make it sound like you're bad, see, because we're sticking up for righteousness. Right. So when as our mental body and emotional and our food body and everything gets clean, oh, we're not supposed to react to that. You're not supposed to react to any of this.
We're supposed to just accept it. It's like,
yeah,
no.
Otherwise you're not liberal and open.
This is the thing. I never claim to be open.
Yeah, me too.
Keep your mind like too that. Open and your brain falls out. Yeah, and we can tell because you guys don't have brains.
Very open to you for that vital information.
But when you want unvital information, you close it. Because I don't need it. I don't need your the pollution.
Well, it's ultimately, I want to have a kid, and if I couldn't support my own son doing that, I can't support you doing that. And that's love to me. Like, I don't care who you are, I'm going to treat you like I would treat my child, in that if my son, you know, was abused and became gay, like, I do not support that. So I can't support that for anybody. It's not how God wanted it to be. It's not what's going to make you happy in the long run.
These behaviors ultimately come from various types of abuse, and I want people to heal from abuse. I don't want them to, you know, I don't want to encourage them to go further into more abusive behaviors that are going to ultimately corrupt their mind, body, and soul. And like I said, if I can't support it for my own child, I can't support it for other people. And it's not that you wouldn't stop loving your child if this happened to them. Because you love them, you want to see them healed. You want to see them become the best versions of themselves possible. And that does not include living in this lifestyle that is corrupting and degrading to their very soul. Like, it's just not what's going to make them the happiest in the long run. And it's, you know, what good parents are going to be supporting, what is ultimately best for their children, no matter what pressures society tries to put on us to support behaviors that go against what is in their own best interest.
The enemy of our soul says we got to accept everything. See, we should accept everything.
Yep.
Let everything.
And if you don't, you're
in.
A bad person.
Yeah. So I don't accept everything.
And the Christ, you know, was against evil. So
yeah.
Who do you follow, the enemy or the Christ?
The Essene Christ is the one who, you know, the teaching of the Essene Christ really changed my life. And the quote that I wanted to share with you is, "Verily I say unto you, they who partake in benefits which are gotten from wronging one of God's creatures cannot be righteous, nor can they touch holy things or teach the mysteries of the kingdom, whose hands are stained with blood, or whose mouths are defiled with flesh." Definitely raising the bar on what we see and call righteousness and, you know, the right way to live. So people are standing around chatting, and three firestorm fighters are going to walk up the hill. Like I was saying earlier, I always deal with these people. So I am, you know, I I'm always watching what's going on, and when I see them starting to come up the hill, you know, I prepare to go and interact with them, because it's just, I'm the point of contact. I have the fire permit. I'm the one setting up the fire. I'm the one that's going to light it and be the one that's, you know, in charge of the situation. So here is that.
Hello. Good. How are you?
Good.
I wish I knew the law. What is the law?
Well, there's no fire restrictions in our apartment, so.
We just learned about you.
What did you learn about?
Not a lot.
Oh, okay.
We just heard about the event tonight.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Coming up here, checking things out, with you guys being safe.
Yeah, I got some vegan food if you guys are interested. And the fire pit is there enclosed, and I have plenty of water underneath this table, so, and a shovel somewhere up there.
And now we have fire support.
In this next clip, I'm, you know, interacting with these firefighters, and they actually mention the event that's going down at Sands Flat, where the anti-Inanna faction is gathered, and the two spaces that these events are taking place are completely different. So the space that I'm in, there's not a tree for, you know, a significant distance, right? Like, we're completely safe in like a field, basically. I mean, there was a little bit of greenery and stuff around, but it's not like there, it's a completely absolutely safe fire area, whereas the people in Sam's Flats are literally surrounded by big trees having a huge fire. So you're actually going to hear them, you know, actually laughing about the size of this fire. So I just wanted to put this in here because people want to try to say, you know, don't have a fire, and try to say that I am some sort of fire danger, when my fires are always like in the middle of fields where nothing else can get lit on fire. So
yeah, we went down to Sand Flats on our way up here. There's quite a few people down there too.
Is there?
Yeah, they got a little fire going
on
top. Yeah.
You hear her laughing. She's like, a little fire. Yeah, exactly. I actually should have sent someone down to get footage of how close it was and how big it was to, you know, in comparison to where it was around all of these trees. But anyways, the discussion continues, and Dustin eventually comes down and, well, the discussion actually comes to fire permit, sorry, is what I meant to say. And then Dustin's trying to, like, pipe in about having this fire permit, and I'm like, no, I'm dealing with them, and he's back here saying, oh, I have a fire. And he's like, no, I'm the one whose event this is. I'm the one who, if you have any issues, you come and deal with me, not this person. Like, that was really trying to, like, step on my toes almost. So, like, no, if there are issues, you come to me. I'm the one in charge here.
I need your fire permit.
I got my fire permit, so.
Right? Super simple, right?
Yep.
I'm
the one that.
Yeah, you're the organizer.
I'm the one.
I've been doing this for 4 years now. Like, I don't need other people trying to chime in and, you know, try to take over. I come in, I set everything up by myself, I handle the whole situation, and I, you know, anyways.
What was your name?
Michael.
Inanna.
Nice to meet you.
Nice for a handshake.
I called you on Instagram yesterday.
Oh. Oh my gosh. Michael.
Yeah.
He's actually really surprised that I, like, knew his name. But I, you know, got a notification that somebody followed me on Instagram, and I'm like, okay, this is interesting. And I see, you know, it's a firefighter, and I obviously creeped on him, like, what's... just trying to figure out what's going on here. So it was really interesting that we had met the next day. We continued talking. We eventually get to talking about the weather and how the weather's really crazy. And Michael's explaining all of these weather systems to me, and it was pretty cool. Oh, also in this background, just listen for Dustin in the background, like...
It's actually starting to not rain anymore. That's really exciting.
You got some stuff coming in behind this.
It's okay.
Oh, there's a...
It's okay. It's zooming that way on the coast. It's out of here. Get
out
of here. Get out of here, low pressure system.
You know, cops and firemen have in common, though, right? They all want to be firemen.
Funny.
Now I feel like I need a walkie-talkie. Right. I said, oh crap, they're all on their way up here to put out my fire.
No one to skedaddle.
Right. No, I'm going to stay here proudly.
I am not going to be running away from my ceremonial fire. You know, I'm going to be standing there. And if it comes to us fighting in court over a ceremonial fire, the right for the freedom to practice religion, you know, I'm down to go to court. So I actually mention in this next clip that if anyone gives me a ticket, I will fight it in court. And this is Michael's response.
I could write a fake-ass ticket.
Thanks. Best ticket ever.
I'll write you permission to burn stuff with his name on it.
I got permission, thank you. Take it up with him, not me.
Remember, it was a short guy.
Right.
Anybody asked, the short guy told you to.
That was a really enjoyable conversation. Men in uniform definitely, you know, have a special spot in my heart, so... that's always fun. As they start walking down the hill, you can actually hear Dustin screaming in the background.
All right, it was great.
Nice meeting you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, guys. We love you.
If you guys get hungry later,
absolutely.
I got desserts too. So,
oh, man, the dessert is bomb.
Fresh homemade bread. Like, I got the work.
This loud, obnoxious behavior, like, makes me look bad. It makes people not want to come to the event. And it's not just that he was vocally being loud, but that loud music is also his music carrying on in the background as well. And that did become problematic later. This next clip, later I was walking up the hill, going back up to the event from the bathroom. And there was a family that was trying to take a picture in front of Mount Shasta. And I asked them if they got a good picture, you know, like, did you get a good one? I'll take one for you if you want me to, so that everybody is in the picture. And this is just kind of... pretty funny, the mom here at the end.
Did you guys get a good one?
Yeah.
Good.
The mom says, okay, we have to do it one more time. Just everyone's like, whoa, no. Anyways, then me and the mom both laughed together. It was cute. But anyways, it's getting later and more people have gathered. I am getting ready to cook for them. Pretty much whenever, you know, I'm all set up and any time people are coming down or up or whatever, it's like, all right, I have my stuff here. I can cook for you. Ultimately, I'm interested in trying to show you that the same types of foods that you love can be made in a vegan version. Not just, you know, going out to the store and getting some chemical, you know, processed food, but like I homemade this food and I've had so many people say it was the best food that they've had in their lives. And that's from non-vegans. Like I want to show people that they can eat these delicious things in a vegan version, not hurt animals, not miss anything and, you know, still enjoy life. So here is the next clip.
Inanna.
Yep.
Don't give
your power.
Okay. And where are you from, Inanna?
I'm originally from Ohio, but I live here. Yeah. Nice. How about you?
I'm originally from Mexico City.
Okay.
And now I moved. I was living in LA County forever, and then I moved to Orange County, and then I put all my shit in storage. Now I'm traveling.
Nice. Yeah. So you're just here. I'm gonna move over this way, so
I might be here a week or two.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah.
Anywhere in specific or just up that way? Just traveling?
Just traveling, but Crater Lake and Plymouth Falls and everything else.
Awesome. Yeah. It's a vegan festival for the full moon.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Vegan festival for the full moon.
Yep.
How do we participate?
Well, you're here now. Are you hungry?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Well, hello. You can grab a plate. It's a little bit messy. Okay. You want to grab that and come back?
Don't check my full moon calendar to see what I'm doing, buddy.
They do end up coming back later, but in the meantime, my friend Baruch, who made the vegan poster, and his wife Maya came to the event, so you're going to hear them arrive. Like I said, Baruch is the talented artist that made that poster, and his vegan chef wife actually brought some goodies to share in the potluck.
I just find a way.
Hello!
I help to carry the wood up the hill?
No, you are coming back. I know. I just.
Tara.
Nothing could be better.
It didn't. It didn't continue to rain. Yeah.
You got more clothes, right?
Hi.
Hello, hello.
Thank you so much.
Sure, look at this.
Glad to see you.
Look. I was so
amazed.
Look,
you have some little energy bites too.
Yes.
I have down there some snickerdoodle ones.
Okay.
So that's really cool.
Okay. This is just sunflower seeds and dates and cacao.
So we had a really, really great turnout for the potluck. I had three or four different other people bring vegan dishes, so that was really cool. In this next clip, you're going to hear the guy from Mexico City. He returned, and I'm cooking him and his friend a burger.
I've never been
vegan.
I never ate a burger in my life, a real burger.
Really?
I was born vegetarian.
What?
So I've never had a burger like this.
Well, this is vegan still.
Right, right. But I mean the regular.
Right, you don't know what to compare it to.
No, exactly. Exactly.
Well, maybe after eating my cheeses.
I would, if I could have access to your cheeses all the time, I would definitely do it. I would do it like
Well, during the golden age, you'll be able to for free.
Have you two met?
Oh, dude.
I know.
I'm Burl.
I want to have replaced McDonald's with the Queen's Kitchen. And have free food 24/7 for everybody that's vegan.
We're both born in Russia.
Then there won't be an excuse. How cool is it that they had never tasted a burger in their lives? Like, I think that is really awesome. And they're not the only person who said, you know, I would go vegan if I had access to your cheese, like, you know, all the time. So that's really encouraging, really exciting. For me personally, I always said I could never go vegan because I could never give up cheese. Now I'm sitting here eating a delicious cheese that I made myself out of cashews. So definitely really exciting time to live and really cool things that you can make with plants, right? In this next clip, I'm going to be talking to my friend Baruch.
Did Elliot reach out to you?
Who? Elliot? Who's Elliot?
He brought up something about somebody being interested in doing like a vegan Shabbat every week or something. So
oh, really?
I said that you would be interested, and I gave him your Facebook. So I didn't know if he reached out to you yet or not.
Not that I recall. No, not somebody called named Elliot. But if he will, that would be wonderful to do Shabbat, vegan
right?
Shabbat.
As soon as he said that, I was like, you got to talk to Baruch because that would be something right up his alley.
That would be amazing. We used to do it a few years ago. There was a lady in town, but she passed. We used to do it in her house. It was very beautiful. Because that's the real spirit of Shabbat, vegan, without murdering animals, you know?
Right.
I wish it would be more prominent amongst the Jews.
Right.
I was here for over 30 years, but I think
And even the indigenous.
I found the shirt I just had to get.
I agree, yeah. Cool. All spiritual groups, religious, they all have to embrace that stuff. It's time.
Right. It's time to put the darkness behind us.
Exactly.
You guys are like the vegans I wish lived in my town.
You guys are like the vegans I wished lived in my town. I love that. That's so exciting. It's actually surprising that there are so few vegans in like this in the area. Some of the anti-Anana faction are vegan, but, you know, they are okay with all the degeneracy that I'm not okay with. They're not really, like, militant vegans. It's like, oh, just let everybody do what they want. Love and light. Oh. Like, love and light does not include killing animals, okay? Love and light doesn't include you sitting around while the people that you claim to love shovel poisons into their mouths, you know, they're killing innocents. It's like love and light doesn't include any of what they are trying to say that it includes, right? Anyways, we continue on talking. Eventually we get around to how unnatural the weather
is. It was really the weather was so weird like an hour ago. It was like
right?
No, they
it was
said
like it, as soon as I got off the phone with you it started sprinkling. I was like, yeah, I just thought that was not raining.
Well, listen what she said. She said it was pouring.
It was, but for a few minutes. Really for a few minutes.
But it wasn't pouring here. It was just drizzling.
So my prayer worked then, because I did pray for it to not rain.
Good.
Come tomorrow, you know, give all the plants some juice tomorrow, but not tonight.
Plants have to be done.
Okay. instead of getting rain, actually, we ended up getting the lava fire, which was not good. So in this next clip, you're going to hear the guy from Mexico City talking about the Age of Aquarius. I thought it was kind of interesting, so I wanted to let you listen in as well.
Talking about like macro astrology.
It's like Aquarian Age, and then we pass the Pisces Age, and then the Aries Age, and the Taurus Age. All those things have big symbolisms all over the Bible, you know?
Right.
And Aquarius Age is Aquarius Age. And you get affected by the opposite sign as well as the current sign. So the opposite sign of Aquarius is Leo. So the effect of that, nobody usually talks, but the keyword of Leo is I dare.
Okay.
So if you see the world, everybody's daring to do all kinds of crazy shit, you know, like today. There's a lot. And Aquarius says, I know. So that's going to be knowledge for everybody. Right. So when you get to that point, beliefs don't matter no more. So there's an arguing about beliefs like the Pisces age. Pisces was, I believe in faith. Now we don't need no faith. Now we know there's no arguing anymore. And we get peace from that and unity.
Right.
Pretty much. That's what the Aquarius age is about.
Yeah.
Dude,
I'm
off in science.
I love that. That was really cool, though, you know. It is true how unifying the truth can be, right? You know, when we all know where we are flat earthers, right? And other truths. Moving from faith to knowing, being solid in that knowing, and then obviously being willing to take that knowing to the extreme, if you're like me, being willing to fight, kill, and die over that truth and spreading that truth to the rest of the world. Very exciting time to live in. So as I am cooking, more people are going to come up to the table, so you will hear some of that in this next clip.
What's your name?
Inanna.
Johnny,
nice to meet you.
Welcome. Yeah, this is surprise. We're just camping right over there. We're like, what's going on?
Oh, what is this?
Nice. I mean, how often do you see a buffet set up here?
Right.
And this. When I drove up, I was like, could that possibly be? So who put on this event?
Me.
Oh, wonderful.
Absolutely. Every full moon, well, from now until October, we'll be up there. Well, we actually usually go all the way up to Siebel.
So Johnny and Tara started to have a conversation about veganism. You're going to hear the tail end of that. I'm kind of working on doing other things, and you'll hear in this next clip what happens.
Which is horrible, which is, you know, crazy.
Yeah, help yourself.
Veal crates.
Thanks a lot.
All of that.
Absolutely.
Same process for chickens. Mm-hmm. So if that mother hen has boy chickens, they basically just smother and kill them all. And then it's an exploitation is basically what it is.
There's some terrible ways.
The exploitation is of the divine feminine. The mother cows are kept in this enslavement, basically a small corral, and being milked over and over, and then re-inseminated to be pregnant again so that they can extract the milk from her. It's just horribly cruel.
Yeah, they're trying to pump everything in it to make it fast and put hormones, anything to make it.
Yeah.
How much can we get it fast and it's not even healthy for us or them or anything?
So then
We're not baby cows. We don't need cow's milk.
Cow's milk, you know, is nature's growth formula for cows. It contains growth factors so that that baby cow will grow into a bigger cow. So those growth factors, when an adult consumes them, they're going to fuel weight gain. They're going to fuel cancer. Milk consumption is linked to cancer, to osteoporosis, to SIDS, to autism, to diabetes. And ultimately, you know, creating a vegan world is the goal so that the humans are better off and the animals are better off. So, yes. Let us, while I'm getting some water, I hear people talking about the Essenes. You know, Tara and Johnny are continuing this conversation. I walk over to get some water. I hear people talking about this. And obviously, you know, as soon as I hear the word Essenes, I'm like, whoop, let me go join this conversation. I love the different conversations that are had throughout the night. So many times they're not shallow conversations, right? They're actually deep conversations like we were having earlier about, you know, the LGBTQ thing, the veganism thing, and this Essene thing, as well as more conversations throughout the night.
I could feel compassion for them. In fact, I didn't even know.
I heard the word Essenes, and I'm like, okay, I'm over here. That's why I'm vegan. So,
yeah, Dolores Cannon. Did you hear about her?
I've heard the name, yeah.
She wrote a book about Jesus Essenes in the Qumran in Israel.
Uh-huh.
A beautiful channeled book. She wasn't channeling, she was a hypnotist, I just told you. But she used to have the clients that she used to take them really high rolls. By hypnosis.
Yeah.
And they used to go and bring some information for her. So she wrote like 14, 15 books about everything. One of them is about the scenes. Jesus and his scenes. Beautiful story. Beautiful story. And it's all, I just, you know, how we could say not harming animals. You know, many people who believe Jesus, Christians, they still eat animals. They don't, they have this missing link. Between, you know,
the compassion of the Christ.
Yes.
There's like on the NazareneWay.com, there's a article that's written about thou shalt not kill, and it says the exact Hebrew phrase meaning actually says killing of any kind whatsoever. So it's like if you actually look into the original meaning of the phrase, it's like a giveaway, right? In the Garden of Eden, nobody killed animals. Like,
give you all the nuts and seeds that you need.
Right?
Yeah, people looking for ascension, liberation.
It says the nuts would be the meat.
Right.
Genesis also.
Right. Raw, herb, and fruit-bearing seed.
And now we have beautiful cheese out of cashews.
Right. Exactly.
Everything.
So it is a little bit of a step up from the garden because we got, well, the technology that we have isn't really that great, but we have all these delicious things, you know. Adam and Eve weren't eating cashew cheese. That's pretty much for sure. But.
Wow, okay. Good to know that you also are connected to Essenes.
Yep.
To Jesus?
Yeah, well, I was studying Passover. I was a Torah follower for a while, so I did like the supposedly clean and unclean meats. And I was, and I was studying Passover, and it says, you know, to do this forever and ever, right? So I'm like talking to my now ex-husband, and I'm like, if we're really serious about following this, it says that we're still supposed to be technically sacrificing animals. Like, we're supposed to go out and get a sheep and keep it for like 14 days and then kill it. I'm like, as a non-vegan, I was like, I can't do that. That's freaking me out even thinking about it. And then I was led to the Essenes and the Gospel of the Holy 12, and it was like, I'm going vegan. And he actually laughed at me because he'd never really seen me eating anything besides like cheeseburgers and stuff. He's like, you're not going vegan. Like, go ahead. And I'm like, it's done. I can't go back on. Right. It says something like, verily I say unto you, those who gain from things that are gotten from wronging one of God's creatures can't be righteous. You can't know the mysteries of the kingdom, and your mouths are stained with blood and flesh. Like, okay, I'm vegan. That's it. I want to be righteous. I want to know the kingdom mysteries. I want to be able to do what I'm here to do.
Exactly. And with discernment, I think that is the kind of, you know, the kind of attitude that is going to change the world. And the discernment, you know, all of the people that you are watching, the pastors that you let pour into your lives, if they're not living a pure life, then why are you following them, right? For me, it's like, I'm not gonna follow anyone that eats animals. You have wrong in your life. You are participating in evil, and you're not gonna be leading me anywhere.
Yeah, they have like a whole thing.
What are the blue rose?
That's what I was thinking that it was, but I wasn't 100% sure. Yeah.
That's the one in Greenwood.
It's interesting because I have a blue rose tattooed on my foot, and I never knew about the Order of the Blue Rose until way after. Yeah, there's a story about the night before Jesus was like arrested, him and Mary, like, you know, they were lovers, and he gave her a blue rose, and it actually makes me cry to even think of the story.
I have read that story. I'll post a link below to the video if you are interested. So at this point in the evening, you know, it's getting dark. We're sitting around this circle. I'm across from Dave and Baruch, who are discussing Trump. Dave's always talking about Trump. And this is where the audio comes in.
Dave, stop talking about Trump.
Get your fire salon.
I'm kidding. I'm really kidding. I'm totally kidding.
I don't come in place.
I know, but I'm not. I was actually just kidding.
I like him better than who's in power, I'll tell you that much.
Well, yeah, things are getting worse over time, but you know how I feel about Trump and Biden together. Well, not together, but they're both
together, yeah.
They're both satanic puppets is what I'm saying.
Okay.
But I just like to tease you about Trump because you got like a Trump shirt or something.
He slipped through the cracks and he wasn't supposed to be there. It was supposed to be Hitler, the great savior.
No one slips through the cracks. Like, Trump was not only bailed out of debt by Rothschild, Trump Tower was funded by Soros, Trump was foreshadowed as president on The Simpsons and Lego Movie. Like, nothing about Trump was uncontrolled. Every president has been selected and groomed for their role. There is no slipping through the cracks when it comes to the reality that we live in. You know, the powers that be, ultimately Satan has complete control over, you know, the situation that is going on in regards to who's being in the top positions of power in the current world that we are living in, the way that it is being run. And first laddies have been males, and presidents have been females. So, you know, if they are lying to you about their sex, then there's nothing else that they won't lie to you about. So you need to be real careful with that.
Hello. Good. How are you?
Good. Happy full moon.
Happy full moon to you too. There's some food down there if you guys are hungry.
We're camping right here.
Oh, nice.
We're going back to our car, and then these really lovely people were like, go up there, there's a vegan potluck, they're really nice. And I was like, oh, yeah. Like, they usually do that on the full moon.
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, we're vegan. They're like, we're your soulmate.
Her and her boyfriend have actually been at other events previously. You know, a lot of people will come to Mount Shasta over and over again, even if they're not locals. During the full moon, you know, their soul just brings them to the mountain. They come camping for a few days or whatever. And then eventually our paths cross. So it's always really cool to see, you know, who comes out and what types of souls the world has for us to interact with.
Building.
Hello.
Like, amazing. Hello. Like,
how's it going?
Really, Elliot.
I'm from Allentown.
So it's like 40 minutes outside.
Sorry. You're in Thrive, right?
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Hello.
Got here. Did I miss this
party?
No.
Okay. I don't like living in LA.
Exactly.
Right. Or fall over.
That'd be awful.
Yeah. Like, yeah, I was kind of trying to migrate.
Right. Yeah, it's close. Well, actually, come over here for a second. Baruch.
Yes.
This is Elliot.
How you doing?
Elliot Baruch.
Ooh. So much tumbling.
Hi, I'm Baruch.
Nice to meet you.
I got you. Nice to meet you, man. Welcome.
I was telling him just a little while ago that I gave you his number or his Facebook for the vegan Shabbat you're talking about.
Oh, yes.
As you can hear, you know, there is a vegan community forming at Mount Shasta, and I definitely plan on having another vegan festival in the future, and obviously continuing the full moon celebrations and all that fun stuff.
No, I ate a bunch of spring rolls as I made them.
Sweet. You could put them out there at the table or just wait until you're ready to do.
Was there a general food time?
People kind of did eat, but there's the ecstatic dance people are supposed to be coming up, I think, and people will come up from the bar. And people will be eating on there.
Did it rain on you?
It did.
Yeah, the water is a little bit warmer.
Cool.
Yeah, but it stopped right before Brew came out.
I'm glad you're on the storm.
Yeah, it was so weird, like it was hot all the day. Suddenly the sky was cloudy. I was like, what the fuck is going on? It didn't rain. I called Inanna immediately. I was like, what's going on up here?
Yeah.
I would imagine that the weather is different than what it's in town, but anyway, it didn't last much, so that's good.
Yeah. I wanted to mention, like, pretty much my fondest memory of Baruch. We were sitting around this drum circle, and Baruch was like,
I wanted to punch this person in the face because they were, you know, pretending that they were such a spiritual person and they weren't vegan. Like, they're talking about punching someone in the face, you know, for not being vegan. It just really brings a smile to my face because it's just militant veganism, right? We should be willing to physically fight for these animals. Like, what are you, if you aren't willing to fight for the weaker species, like, where's your strength and your courage? If you have to prey on those weaker species to feel strong, well, that definitely is very telling about the weakness of your character.
So, Jana, you mentioned something about enemies that are trying to ruin this event. Did anything happen so far?
Nothing happened, but there's also cops that were sitting down there, so...
Obviously, law enforcement presence is going to discourage trolls from coming, and a lot of the people, you know, they'll talk online, all this stuff, and then when it comes down to actually getting off their butts and doing something, they're nowhere to be found. Plus, who wants to come out to this event, you know, and potentially get into an altercation with me?
I didn't come and say anything to you, did they?
The cops came up, but I haven't had any, like, civilians cause any problems, so okay. That's good.
No, these cops didn't come up.
Not these. When I first got here, there was two cop cars sitting there waiting for me.
Oh, really?
Someone on Facebook actually said, there will be lots of law enforcement up there waiting for you. Please don't start a fire.
Like,
the people are having fires at Bunny Flats every night. But you're going to tell me not to have a fire?
I just talked to them and they said, because somebody said there was going to be a battle.
Yeah.
Oh, well, yeah. It's the Battle of Bunny Flats. And
they were like, what
battle? What battle?
Well, the battle between anyone that wants to come cause problems and me.
It's pretty much as simple as that, right? My intent was that I am going to have a great vegan festival, and if somebody causes problems, then, you know, then it turns into a battlefield, and we'll see in a little bit what kind of battlefield it ended up turning into, and we'll just have to be patiently waiting.
When I moved to Mount Shasta, I thought like there's gonna be so many vegan people here.
Right.
I had like I was delusional a little bit.
You're hopeful. It's like.
And then I was like, what? And I realized.
There's not even one fully vegan restaurant here. It's like.
There is none.
Yeah.
Barry fail.
They told me I had to have a vaccine and not wear a mask, so I went home and I came back with a vaccine. I was like, yeah.
I identify as vaccinated.
I'm banned from Berryville.
Yeah, you said that because you gave them. You wrote that opinion paper or whatever.
I wrote a letter. No, because I wrote when the COVID bullshit started. I basically wrote a letter and I accused them harassing their employees with those masks. You know, harassing and the clients. And I basically wrote that they're fascists.
They've kind of gone on and off with enforcing the masks. Now they're not enforcing them right now. But we'll see as the winter progresses what type of, you know, things they do try to enforce. They were pretty bad with it last time, having somebody sitting outside of the store, you know, telling people that they need a mask, counting the people that go in and out and all of that stuff. So, yeah.
And it was so cool because we come down the mountain and where we live, we're the only vegans.
Oh, really?
Like, It's so, like, we can't even talk about it really because we'll just be trash mouthed.
Right.
So, when I came down and, like, the first thing I hear is, I'm like, oh my god, I've got to go over
a vegan festival.
So, I actually have a vegan raw food company.
Really?
I make and sell chocolates and sprouted crackers.
Really?
And, like, sprouted trail mix.
How long have you been doing that?
License and all the fancy stuff. Let's see.
I say fancy because I did all the stuff.
Right.
Let's see, Ayla 17, so 13 years.
Wow, that's impressive.
Yeah, I love it. Oh my god, it feels so good.
That was the lady who had come before and said that they were going to go do ecstatic dance and come back. We chatted for a little bit longer, and then another couple came down from the mountain.
You guys headed out?
I'm getting tired.
Well, can we maybe come back. So you guys are gonna stay whole night, yeah?
Yep.
Yep. Very easy.
Yeah, no, it's amazing.
I'm glad that you guys could stop by.
Yes, it's a surprise.
This is like eye-opening experience.
Yeah. We'll come for July.
Absolutely, I would love that. Thank you.
So the drumming started, you know, night falls, and Dustin was still trying to play music out of his little speaker. You can actually hear in this next clip, this little kid is like, this guy really wants to listen to music. It's kind of funny.
Hopefully I'll get it. It just says, hey.
I know.
Does he go up and compete with the drum circle?
I guess. Here we go.
I think that there might be intoxicants involved.
Yeah, I actually planned to go up and talk to him after this little conversation. I was going to go tell him to turn off the music while people were drumming. It's like, it's a drum circle. Once the drumming starts, turn off the music. But in the meantime, this guy named Oliver actually came up and started to talk to me. So I got distracted with that. And
drive safely.
Thanks for your hospitality, for doing all this.
Absolutely. Did you get any food or are you hungry?
Yes, I did.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Listen closely in this next clip for Dustin carrying on in the background.
I'll just send my name really quick to you, and then you can have my name.
Is it okay to put this right here?
Yeah. Cool. What exactly is an energy gift?
In this next clip, in the background, you'll hear Baruch actually say, "Excuse me, can we play drums here?" to Dustin, trying to get Dustin to turn off the music. Yeah, like I said earlier, once the drums start, it would be an obvious thing to turn off the music and let the people start to play the drums, but...
So, like if what I've observed is when people have, like, arthritis or something like that, it's like, they have trouble, like, always, you know, trying to do...
Excuse me, can we play your drums?
Yeah, Thanks.
I was about to do the same thing after you're done talking.
So as I am talking to him about energy healing, you know, Reiki, Tom actually comes down, and this is where all of those pieces earlier that I was telling you were relevant are really going to come together in this next audio clip.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to take off because
next moon with me.
Some of the elements here are not going to work out for me.
Okay.
That's too bad.
Is it anybody else's specific?
Well, he was listening to that rap music.
I was actually about to come up and say something.
Now, when they look at me, they're like, oh, we're going to fuck with you. They want to get rowdy with me. I have a feeling because he's already insulted my flute playing, so now I can't play the flute around him without...
He insulted your flute playing?
Yeah, he did.
I really like Tom, and the fact that Tom was insulted by Dustin regarding his flute playing really, really grinds my gears. Like, it makes me want to hurt somebody because, like I was saying earlier, I really value Tom's friendship, and for this to happen really is extremely, it's crossing the line. He said that Dustin not only insulted his flute playing, but that Dustin and his friend were looking at him like they wanted to fight him, basically. So because of this, he ends up leaving. And this is Tom, somebody who I've had nothing but pleasant experiences with. He comes to my full moon celebrations. He watches my food. He defends me. And then he gets insulted by someone who has caused nothing but problems for me.
Yeah, and I actually warned him before he came that I was worried about him coming and drinking and causing problems.
Yeah,
so. I
mean, he was like here at the beginning, so yeah. he's on something and I don't like, I think it's meth maybe, I don't know.
He thought that he was on meth, so yeah, I don't know. In the next clip, we're getting closer to midnight, and some people have left because of the obnoxiousness of Dustin, and another group of suspicious people came up like right before midnight, and the fact that they came up like right before I was about to, you know, go into my prayer really already put me on edge. I know how to transvestigate. I understand that I am surrounded by these kinds of clowns, and that they purposefully will come to my parties to cause problems. So this is what I was expecting from them. And here is a clip that you'll hear her.
I just want to make sure that we have silence during the prayer so we don't have to have violence. A promise, actually. That if there's not silence, there will be violence.
I wanted to warn them, you know, I'm going to be saying my prayer, and I expect you to be respectful. I've put on this event. I've created this space. I have homemade all of this food, and the very least that you can do is not interrupt my not even 2-minute prayer. Like, give me at least one little bit of respect. And if you can't be quiet during that, then just walk away. Go somewhere else. Go hang out somewhere else, you know. And if you want to stay here and do cause problems, well, then we're going to have problems. So, yeah, I wanted to actually play this next clip so that you can hear some of the utter obnoxiousness of these entities. So, you know, you already had heard Dustin carrying on. Now, these other people that come to the party, it's basically like just...
Go to hell with the BLM signs outside. Woo! Yeah, because they're sellouts. They're Woo! Sellout people. Okay, they act like
there was an incident.
Yeah, they're sellouts. They want us to wear masks.
I mean, the schools. The
when
school.
I said all life matters, they went. A 20-year-old woman, like Boat's she knows way more than me, looked at me and she looked like.
By Miles Ooh! Power.
And I went, "What? Are you a racist? You don't believe all life matters?
Save our roads. Save our planet."
Is it there yet? No. I'll try it again next year.
So in the next clip, I am going to play the video footage from the prayer. And I will catch up with you after that.
Omnimatter Ergo Logos Inanna 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 Aika. Omnimatter Ergo Logos Inanna 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 Aika. Honey matter ergo logos inanna 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 aika. Please bring on the golden age and help us to change this world into a better place. I am Inanna, obviously, and this is a vegan festival because the meeting place of heaven and earth should be vegan. And the ultimate thing that comes down to is that humans will continue to be enslaved as long as we enslave the animals, and the golden age is a golden age where humans and the animals can be free to explore and not have to worry about day-to-day, you know, putting food on the table, right? We should be able to eat for free and enjoy life and have fun. So that is what the golden age is about. That's what this whole demonstration is all about, and I'm thankful that you are all here. So thank you for coming.
After my prayer, I actually brought out my guitar and tried to play a song with Dave, but these clowns like were just singing and then making obnoxious noises through the song and ruined my recording. So it's extremely frustrating. But after this all happened, a friend came up and asked about those people who were making noise during the song, and I wanted to play this for you.
Who?
Those two girls, not guys?
No, I think they're
Think they're what?
Sexuals that came here to sabotage my fucking
that
song.
That's kind of what I was thinking. I didn't get the part, but...
Well, it really threw me off.
We live in a completely controlled reality, and my enemies are constantly surrounding me trying to cause issues, so it's really not surprising. Just listen to how obnoxious these souls are. I mentioned to a few people that I think that they're having a competition to see who can be the most obnoxious. Like, I'm not even joking. What was that? You see what I'm saying, though?
Like, at least you had a really good turnout earlier. A lot of people here.
right?
Yeah, that's pretty good. Everybody did like the food.
Yeah. What must have been a surprise for some people.
Right. Well, I've been advertising it a lot, but people keep ripping down my poster at Berryvale.
Sure. Yeah. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Some people have it in for you.
Including people at this fucking fire.
Oh, yeah.
Even people who pretend to be my friends are, you know, often just inverse or assets, just pretending and trying to undermine me, trying to cause all sorts of issues and just be obnoxious and irritating.
No, the world is so fucked up. Twitter can go to hell and face crook, fascist crook. CNN is controlled by CIA. They're going after Orange Man and blowing this new guy, Biden, who's at the, you know, going on down on the New World Order as fast as he can. Sorry, I'm getting really grabbed.
No, I'm not even saying that about what you're saying, but just the fact that you think that Trump is against it just pisses me off.
Well, I believe that, yes. I really do. That he's against a lot of factions in the New World Order.
Everything about Trump is control. Dave, like I was saying earlier, actually has a shirt that has Trump on it. And one of these times they were wearing it to my full moon celebration. I went up to like try to hug it. I'm like, oh, I don't think I want to hug you because you have that shirt on. Just like always giving Dave a hard time. It's fun.
No one gets to be president unless they're part of the bloodline or part of the club. This guy thinks that Trump somehow weaseled her way in. Her, yes. Trump is a female, transsexual, without a penis. Like the porn stars will get manholes because they knew that they passed, but the rest of their bits. Actually a double switch. So she was born female and then was male to win the Olympics, right? So she actually was a trick to become the Olympics and now she's going back. So it's kind of, it is, it's like a mind fuck really, but yeah.
They can, I didn't think they could go back into the full switch unless they didn't do a full switch.
Yeah, they usually don't. They usually don't do things with their bottom bits so they can still have sex. Who wants to have a life without sex? Like even if you're fucking.
Well, no, he said with him, he
well, the funny thing is that he never had a penis to begin with, because it was always a female.
That makes sense.
Right. Turn it on me and I'm like,
no, exactly.
I have shown my hips. Any real transvestigator knows that hips are the golden standard. So it's like, I'll show all of my biomarkers and people are like, you're trans. I'm like, no.
And the thing that kills me is that the people that bitch and complain won't give you any reasoning behind why they're saying what they do.
Right.
Beautiful.
And I mean, my mind is
beautiful.
Really open. Surprised if they do that. If they don't do that, I mean, that's.
Well, yeah, and I have people that like in the transvestigation group. They're trying to say I am. I'm
Goddess
like, you're a faceless
north,
coward. Where are your biomarkers? You have the audacity to
yes,
come at me,
vocals.
And when you're a transsexual, you're
fired. This is the vision of how
started.
Yeah, oh, thanks baby. For the. Hey, Dustin.
Did he even play a song?
I'm the fire starter. I started the fire.
Dustin actually did try to start the fire, but when I saw them, like I saw the fire being lit, I'm like, what is going on right now? This is my event. This is my ceremonial fire. Every month I come here and do a full moon celebration. I pray over this fire. I light it. Like, what are you doing? No, this is not happening. So, yeah. I don't know if you heard it. I mean, how could you miss it in that last clip? But this person that was, there was two supposed girls and a guy, and the guy had this beer bottle, and they were just tap, 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 tap against this rock, like, this whole time. And I swear when that thing finally broke, I was so happy. I'm like, yes, thank God that bottle finally broke, because that was so annoying. Oh my gosh, these people. All right, we are getting really close to the confrontation happening, people. So let us keep moving forward.
Why are we singing about lions?
So do you hear, I remember that a while, I don't know, it's probably a long time ago, you were doing a video about on YouTube about arming yourself and you had your guns. Did they demonetize you or like ban those videos?
I'm not monetized. Okay. So sometimes there are commercials that'll play during my videos, but yeah, it's because of the ending music. It's like because I use their music, they can put commercials in my shit.
I don't know how it all works. I just know there's a couple of channels that I follow in. They're like, if they say the word gun or show a gun, they get demonetized instantly. And so they say pew pews.
I've always refused to be monetized because I don't want people to say, oh, you're just doing this for money. It's like, I don't want money. Like, I'm not doing any of this for money. I'm doing it to change the world. I actually believe the things that I'm saying. It's not that I'm trying to...
Yeah, like this. I don't know how much all this costs you. It costs you way more money or way more in time.
Hundreds of dollars, but yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You put a tip jar or anything up?
I don't take tips.
Do you work at all?
I'm a homesteader, and I have some friends that like own businesses, so I can do stuff.
Well, yeah, I knew you were homesteader. I didn't know, right. I mean, but you don't have like a corporate job or anything.
I do like odds and ends jobs for my friends that have their own businesses, so I can work from home and do my own schedule and all that. So,
all right. It is time for the moment that we have all been waiting for, the intro to the confrontation. You've already heard some of the obnoxious behavior that these people are participating in. Like, I have been driven to my breaking point. Like, I was just so annoyed with these people. I was about to explode. So, yeah, the guy that I was talking to just a bit ago is starting to show me this video, which I'm going to play for you here on the screen as well, so that you can see what I was seeing and what I was reacting to. So, here we go.
Not too hot?
Kind of uncomfortable, but...
Put it out there.
Creepy looking creature. This is an obvious. Look at that thing.
They have like other, if you see other pictures of her, she doesn't look anything like that. They,
oh, really?
Yeah, it's like they're doing it because of the video. But nowadays, you don't, I mean.
Well, they got a curved back forehead. You can't really change that.
Children for losing.
different year if I identify as a female than when my balls and penis disappear.
That's hilarious that they just said I identify as a female, and I was just thinking that it was actually a trans. So that's funny. They're everywhere. They're all over. Yeah.
Yeah.
I like things the way God intended them to be.
I mean, they're definitely who they are as they are.
Actually, God made them one way and then they try to be another thing, which is actually a lie. No, I'm talking about the Creator.
I mean, people are allowed to be whoever they want.
Yeah, we have free will. You could be a pedophile if you want, but it doesn't make it right.
It's actually different. So you get people too?
I would not support my own child being that, so I cannot support anybody else being that.
Well, that's pretty sad. That's heavy, dude.
How is that sad? Why would you be okay with your son being pounded in the ass? Are you kidding me?
That's
wrong. That's weird.
Cool.
No.
Alright, I've had enough of your white supremacist bullshit.
Oh, yeah, because white has anything to do with it.
Honestly, at this rate, I'm starting to feel like it is.
It is racist. What does it have to be do with being white? Like, who cares what color, skin color somebody is? Like, if I was any other color, I'd have the same feelings. When did I talk about being loving? When did I talk about that? Wait. When did I pray for love? I didn't pray for love. Should I get out the recording? What did I never said anything about love, sweetheart. Bye. Bye.
Activism saved the planet. No more plastic straws and paper.
Yes, and I don't agree with people calling people trans. I don't agree with derogatory terms.
They call themselves trans.
That's what, like, how can you not agree with that?
Yeah, see, there's people like right there.
Where did you grow up then?
They call themselves that. It's like,
where did you come from?
Did you hear me? There's like people like right there.
Right. Yeah.
No, that's what they say yes, they are. Called. Hello.
I know.
That's all it took out to take up on 2 hours.
I love that. If that's all it would have taken, I would have played that song 2 hours. That was hilarious. Oh my gosh. All you gotta do to clear out a fire is just say the train. So in this next clip, we're discussing the people who just left, and my friend Dave says, you know, I don't think that she's an invert.
Listen, I don't think she's a trans.
Well, you're entitled to your opinion, but,
I do
I'm
think
actually
she's
a master at transvestigation. I've taught over 10,000 people how to transvestigate.
Okay, I don't know. You're talking about the shoulders and the hips.
Yeah, different biomarkers, yep. Yep. And plus, I can kind of just tell with people the way people act sometimes. It's like, that's just obvious. It's not normal human behavior.
Oh,
it's,
she wasn't acting at all normal, but that's not the point.
That's hilarious.
We're leaving. We're going to another sand flat crash in that drumstick.
Let me go tell them how white supremacists. What?
Well, that was a compliment. Not that we're white supremacists. I don't believe in that shit.
No, but she called me white supremacist.
I know because she was probably hanging around Portland or something with the idiot Antifa people that don't.
Well, who
know
called
anything.
You a Nazi earlier?
Oh, yeah. The one with the face paint said something about not being a Nazi.
Who said not being a Nazi?
Well, because the guy was asking me if he could retune my guitar and
oh,
shit.
Oh, that's right, yeah. That's
and then this bitch over here saying, yeah, and I'm like, you don't tell anybody what
no,
to
you
do
had a
with
good point.
My guitar.
You had
like,
a good point. Then I said, yeah, well, you guys
like,
aren't
oh,
communists,
sorry
are you?
For being a Nazi. It's
and
like,
I said to her, I was like, I'm surprised you even let her use her.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah, yeah.
Let him so use your instrument.
It's called, we can do what we want with our private property.
During the Golden Age, you know, people can actually own their own property, stuff that can't be taken from you, from the government, right? In a socialistic state, the government essentially owns everything and can take anything from you and redistribute it, and you have to pay taxes on it, and in the Golden Age, that is not the case. People can actually own their things, they can be free, but in this current, you know, world that we are in, the current situation, the only thing that you really own is, when it comes down to it, those things that you are willing to fight, kill, and die over. Like, that's kind of how it is in the system that we are in, and that definitely needs to change. So in this next clip, we are talking about Ascended Masters. My opinion on it is that if you're in this world, right,
yeah.
And you claim to be an Ascended Master,
yeah.
that means you came from below because you ascended and you're here. If you came from above, you're a descended master, right?
That's a good point.
I'm a descended master because I know I came from above. I didn't come from below.
Oh, I like that, girl.
And plus, it's like an ass-ended master. It's kind of just not something that you want to be calling yourself.
Yeah, especially a guy.
Right. Like,
and don't end up in prison.
That comes off just a little bit wrong.
So at 3:33, I break out my guitar, and Dustin, of all people, is the one who ruins my recording then by just making obnoxious noises and being just generally interruptive during the time that I'm trying to play. Extremely frustrated. So I was already annoyed with that. I was annoyed with the obnoxious, you know, behavior. I was annoyed with the fact that Tom was insulted. So by the time, you know, the morning comes around, like, I have already had it, you know, to my breaking point with Dustin. And when everybody else was around, you know, I'm trying to handle the situation with kid gloves. But when it's just me and Dustin, like, the gloves come off. Unfortunately, I left my phone down on the top of the car. But you'll actually hear, you'll hear towards, like, I'm coming down the hill and towards the end of the argument. So anyways, everybody left besides me and Dustin, and I'm starting to tidy everything up, and basically he starts to pester me about when he can see me again. I'm like, dude, I don't know. You know, I'm already annoyed with you. We've had some major issues tonight. We've had major issues for a while now. Like, there are serious issues here, and you begging me to hang out with me, like, you know, out of desperation is really not gaining you any brownie points. Yeah, like, once I'm done with a full moon event, specifically, the next day, it's like, I'm going home and I'm going to pass out. Like, I have been up for the past few days baking and cooking all of this stuff. Like, I was up all night entertaining people, hosting the event. I'm exhausted. I just want to go home and go to sleep. And, you know, so that was kind of, like, my mindset. And, yeah, at some point, he was trying to say that we are the same and all of this stuff. And it's like, I totally lost it. It's like, no, we're not on the same mission. The last time I talked to you, you're talking about feeding a child McDonald's. Like, just serious issues on top of the fact that you just insulted my friend Tom and he went home because of you. He has never left early for my event. And now he says that because of you, he has left. And I kept bringing this up. It's like, you know, why would Tom tell me this if it wasn't true? Why would he leave if it wasn't true? He's never lied to me before. And Dustin's coming from a place, you know, oh no, that didn't happen. I never insulted him. I didn't say that, you know, I was respectful, all of this stuff. So not accepting any of the situation, just like denying it, all of these issues, right? So, yeah. You are going to hear the sort of the end of this conversation then. And I also brought up the fact that I didn't want him to come to my event drunk and cause problems. That's exactly what happened. And yeah, so I'm bringing down the last things. He's following me and asks me, you know, again, after at least 30 minutes of arguing, when he's going to see me again. So you should be able to hear that in this next clip here. I don't know you that well, and I don't know.
I'll tell you right now, when the guy said,
I don't like your music.
That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about him saying that you don't want to hear him playing the flute. That's what he was offended about.
I never said nothing like that.
That's what he told me. I don't know.
Dude, I'm a music lover.
I wasn't there.
I would never say anything like that.
I wasn't there.
I love flute. I love piano. I love everything about music. I would never say anything like that.
Well, I wasn't there, so I don't know, but here's all your stuff. Make sure it doesn't stay here, please. I don't want to get in trouble for it.
For what?
All this stuff.
No.
I said make sure that you take your shit, is what I'm saying.
Great. I'm so glad you're so mad at me. You know what? I would never tell someone that they're not a good flute player. I love music. I would never tell
them
that.
He said that he wasn't a good flute player. He said that you didn't want to hear it.
I would never say that. I love flute. I love music. There's no way I would tell some guy who's older than me, for one. I respect my elders. So, for one, I would never say to somebody who's awesome at music, like, I don't want to hear your music. I would never do that. I would never do that. I would never, ever, ever do that, dude. You don't... I wish you knew better. I would never insult somebody. Do you think I'm going to insult somebody?
Drunk people do stupid shit all the time, so I don't know. Well, I wasn't drinking, but you were. And I said I was worried that you're going to come here and drink and cause problems. I can't stand being around drunk people. So it doesn't win you any brownie points with me to come to my event and drink. I can smell the alcohol when you're so fucking close to me. Drunk. It's disgusting me. Dude, I don't like it.
And after that, I drove away. This is definitely an eventful ending to an eventful celebration, from crazy weather to, you know, fighting over inverted clowns to all of that drama that happened in the morning with Dustin. Hopefully you enjoyed hearing the audio from the Battle of Bunny Flats, and I would love for you to come out to one of my events in the future. Each one is different crowds of people, different, you know, things happening, and even if there is drama, you know, we always have a lot of fun, great fellowship around the fire. So hopefully you will come out to one of my full moon celebrations this coming summer, obviously on Mount Shasta. And yes, thank you for spending this time with me. I hope that you enjoyed, and I hope that you have a wonderful rest of the year.
A fairy tale, a piece of fiction. Tell me she's make believe. Got a body who could never dream of. Novellas, game shows, and fancy dreams. Living way lavish on fancy things. In high definition, HD so clean. Playboy bunny like the girl next door. She Snow White, and I'm Hugh Hefner. Fresh tasket, Christian Dior. With the body of a temple, I must explore. Girl, I must incline. Twerk it down low with that behind. Tell me as I'm dreaming, or you just that fine. If you got imagination, then imagine mine. A fairy tale, a piece of fiction. Tell me she's make-believe. Got a body who could never dream of. Twilight, my night, brand new moon. Look at the illusion across the room. Daytime, nighttime, girl, afternoon.
Doing the most for Dolce & Perfume.
Now how am I gonna handle this? iPhone, MacBook, Blu-ray disc. And she look like she coming from a video. You know the ones they say, sure to get it loud. Sipping sangria, mamma mia. Welcome everybody to my fantasia. Way more style than a fashionista. My freak in the shit's my diamond diva. A fairy tale, a piece of fiction.
Come on,
tell me she's